हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवन फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 64। Amazon has restricted its delivery service in at least 2 cities in India to comply with the lockdown guidelines. The e-commerce giant is now delivering essentials only in Delhi and Mumbai, where the state governments have imposed strict lockdowns in the wake of the steep surge in COVID-19 crisis. Both Delhi and Maharashtra are the worst hit states in India, not only in the terms of daily COVID-19 positive cases, but also from the purview of shortage of medical supplies. Amazon therefore is only fulfilling the needs for essential items in at least these 2 cities. Apple CEO Tim Cook has pledged aid to India as the COVID-19 crisis is deepening by the day. Cook said that Apple will be donating to support and relief efforts on the ground. This comes soon after Google CEO Sundar Pichai and Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella announced their plans to support India and various Indian organizations in the fight against the outbreak. India has emerged as an hotspot of COVID-19 globally, reporting over 3.5 lakh cases daily amid an acute shortage of medical supplies. The registration for vaccination for those 18 to 45 years old opened up finally on Wednesday at 4 p.m. and as expected, servers of the Cowin app and website, Umang app and Arogya Setu app has been crashed. Soon after the Arogya Setu app started working, additionally the Cowin website worked well for the users instead of the application. Users took to Twitter to complain about the server crashing. Earlier, users had also complained that they were not receiving the one-time password required to log in to the applications. Realme has announced that it is postponing the Realme X7 Max launch in India. The company decided to postpone the launch due to the COVID-19 second wave that has hit the country. The launch event was slated for May 4th, where the company was going to launch the Realme TV as well. These two products will now be unveiled at the later date. Realme India has not announced the new launch date of its upcoming products. Apex Legends is one of the most popular battle royale games currently available for PCs and console. Now Respawn Entertainment and Electronic Arts has its sights for conquering mobile. The game was recently made available for pre-registration globally and now seems to be in its early access stage with the people who have already pre-registered for the game receiving it. Note, the game is currently not available for all the Android users. As of now, is only available to the users who pre-registered last week. Dogecoin is emerging as a new hot cryptocurrency and has given exponential returns to its investors since the beginning of 2021. Now a 33-year-old Los Angeles resident has shared his story, claiming that he became a Dogecoin millionaire on April 15th. Glober Contisito shared a YouTube video where he revealed that he had invested over $180,000 in Dogecoin, where its price is about 0.045 cents in February. He confirmed his millionaire status on Reddit by sharing a screenshot on his holdings on Robinhood. "Hey guys, I just became a Dogecoin millionaire," he wrote, attaching the screenshot. Microsoft has announced the date for this year's Build Developer Conference. The Build 2021 will be held from May 25th to May 27th. In addition to confirming the dates, the tech giant has also opened up registration for the same. It will begin with a keynote from Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella on May 25th at 8:30 p.m. IST. Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 is a top-end chipset for smartphones available right now, and it is powering most of the flagship smartphone launched this year. Recently, it was reported that some Chinese companies are working on the devices powered by unannounced Snapdragon 888 Pro chipset. According to the sources, the smartphone maker Honor is among those companies. Those are working on the smartphone that will be powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 Pro processor. Sina Digital has posted some exciting news on its official Weibo account. Sina claims that Oppo is no planning to enter the car market or the automobile industry. The smartphone manufacturing company is said to be entering the car manufacturing. The company has not revealed anything officially on this matter. OnePlus Nord N10 successor has received IMDA certification. This phone bears a model number EB2103. The IMDA certifications only reveal 5G, 4G, LTE, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, NFC and GPS connectivity features. Samsung Galaxy M42 5G introductory price in India is set for ₹19,999. It features a 6.6 inch HD+ AMOLED display and it comes with a Snapdragon 750 chipset and it runs on 48 megapixel quad camera setup and it also has a 5000 mAh battery with 15 watt fast charging. Samsung Galaxy M42 5G first sale begin on May 1st. family of Lee Kun-hee, a chairman of Samsung Electronics, revealed that they will pay more than 12 trillion won inheritance taxes for the estate and donate the vast private art collection to state curators. The price could be approximately $10.8 billion. According to the reports, the tax won't be paid in a single instance. The family said that they are planning to pay the tax bill over a period of 5 years in a total of 6 installments starting this month. Xiaomi and Samsung has apparently partnered up to produce a new custom silicon. The two firms have reportedly held 5 meetings so far regarding the development of new processor based on ARM Cortex-X2 cores. ARM has yet to announce a Cortex-X2, although the new architecture is expected to be unveiled later this year. Similar to the partnership between the Chinese and the South Korean tech giant, Qualcomm is also expected to adopt the new version 9 architecture for its upcoming flagship processor. Even Samsung would likely to use the new cores for its competing Exynos-based processor as well. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.